Oh, praise the Lord, praise Master Jesus, praise the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Our precious Daddy, Lord, we just thank you for such a time as this. I pray that you will verify your word in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Amen. May the Lord continue to strengthen you and your family in the name of Jesus. I welcome you to Prophetic Assignment with Prophetess Mrs. Roslyn, wife of New Life in Christ Evangelical Ministry. Praise God. I trust God for your life. I believe God is doing wonders in your life. I pray that the Lord continues to strengthen you in the name of Jesus. As the year is running to an end, God has already prepared a great thing ahead of us in 2020. Hallelujah. By the grace of God, I will be giving us what the Lord has been communicating with me. Praise God. His own son and his own son. It has been an awesome time in his presence, hearing from God, his own son. Praise God. We have hope. We have hope. Praise God. And what I'll be bringing to us today is back to your first love. Back to your first love. That is the stepping stone to 2020. You have to come back to your first love. Praise God. You have to recognize that Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he loves you. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, the Almighty God, the God that created the universe, the God that made the earth, the footstool that watches over the affairs of men, the God that never sleeps nor slumber, the Ancient of Days, the lily and the valley, the bright and morning star, the rose of Sharon, the God that created that was not created, the Almighty God. I mean the one that sent his only begotten Son, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of Israel, the God that never sleeps nor slumber, the God that is watching over you, the God that said he will never leave you nor forsake you, the God that has been there for you. If not God by your side, tell me where you would have been. If not God by my side, it will be a different story. That is why I bless God every day of my life. Brethren, I want you to begin to thank God for your life. The Lord has brought you to the month of December. He's taking you to 2020 with a great expectation. Hallelujah. His own son, his own son. His word has been very promising. Praise God. Full of hope. Praise God. He wants us to be connected to him as we are preparing to sail into the year 2020, a new dispensation, a new era for us all as a child of God, a year that will be full of expectation. Praise God. Even full of expectation, we should be expecting the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm not saying he's coming in 2020. As a children of God, we are supposed to be expecting Jesus Christ to show up at any time for the rapture to happen, for the saint to be raptured with him. Praise God. I hope you are preparing. Praise God. Because God loves you so much. According to John 3 verse 16, I know it's a popular scripture. It's a popular scripture that you can quote from even without opening your Bible. But I love to open the Word of God, the Bible. Praise God. No matter what, I like to read from the Bible. Praise God. I'm going to be taking my reading from John 3:16. Say, for God so loved the world, for God so loved this world, and he gave his only begotten Son, which is the reason for the season. Praise God. God, Jesus is the reason for the season. It was God's love that made him to give us his Son, Jesus Christ. So God is our first love. Praise God. God is the author of love. God is love. That is why when Jesus came, he came with so much love that he loved the sinner. He wants the sinner to repent. He wants everybody, anyone that has gone astray, to come back. That is it. That is what I mean by come back to your first love. If you have gone astray, remember that God loves you. Remember this. God loves you. Jesus loves you. That is why God gave us Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Praise God. He loves you, that Anytime you have gone astray, never you feel that you don't have a father that loves you. Always remember that your first love, which is God the Father, who created the whole universe, who created you in his own likeness and in his own image, the one who profound love, the one that is love himself, loves you. He wants you to come back to him. He wants you to reconcile with him. He wants you to come back to him. He loves you. He loves your soul. He doesn't want you to go to hell. He doesn't want you to die in that situation. He doesn't wants you to condemn yourself. He wants you to come back. No matter how filthy you are, no matter how dirty you are, he wants you to come back. The blood of Jesus is enough for you. He said he gave us his only begotten son, the only one, that whosoever that believeth in him should not perish. Whosoever, it doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter your background. It doesn't matter who you are. Whosoever, black, white, yellow, green, whosoever you are, whosoever you are, should come to him. He said so that you will not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. Have everlasting life. What life do you want? That is a promising life, a life without an end, a life without struggle, a life with so much promise. He said, I have gone to prepare a place for you, and I will come back to again to receive you unto myself, that where he is, there you will be. What a promise. What a lovely promise. What an awesome promise. Praise God. He wants you. God is your first love. For you to go back to your first love is through Jesus Christ. Total change. Building your personal relationship with God. Brethren, if you know that you have missed it in one place, your first love is not your wife. Your first love is not your husband. Your first love is not your pastor. Your first love is not your parents. Your first love is not your friend. Your first love is not your colleague. Your first love is not your neighbor. Your first love is not you. Your first love is God. For you to go back to your first love is through Jesus Christ. If you have missed it, you have gone astray. You have shifted. You have drifted from the word of God. You are no longer focused on the word of God. You used to believe. You used to trust God. You used to wait on God. But suddenly, you don't want to wait on God any longer, because the pressure of the system is pressurizing you to give up on your faith. And you have even shifted or drifted from it. The Lord is wanting you. This message is for you. He wants you to come back to him. Jesus is awaiting you. Jesus don't want you to end this year without reconciling with him. He wants you to reconcile with him. He wants you. Yes, yes, he loves you. He loves you. Look at me. Look at the word of God. This is prophetess Mrs. Roslyn, the wife, who telling you that the Lord is awaiting you. This is not a word to cajole you. This is a word that the Lord has released to me to prophetically give to the world, that the Lord awaits us. As many that has gone astray, because a great revival is going to blow. Yes, yes. Because the revival is going to be a very short one. It's going to be a very short one. That as many that will listen to the true word of God and be connected and build their relationship with God will see Christ when he returns. Yes. We are going to see a great revival back to your first love. The Lord told me about 3 years ago, this message, that I should tell the people to come back to their first love. Yes, I've preached it in my ministry. Those that have been in the ministry, New Life in Christ Evangelical Ministry, can testify of this message, because this is what the Lord, I don't speak what the Lord does not give to me. I speak prophetically the way God wants me to speak it. Praise God. This is a divine assignment for me to call you to back to first love. Because a lot of people think their wife, their husband is their first love. No. God first. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit is your first love. Then when you want to come back to him, it's through Jesus Christ. There is no other way, because any other way that sinneth right to a man, the end thereof is destruction. Praise God. Are you excited? Are you happy that Jesus Christ has already paid the price for you? He loves you with all love, with all godliness. He wants you to live a righteous life and a holy life so that when he comes and you will see him. Are you preparing your soul, your mind, your spirit? Oh, yes, let it be connected to him. And I want to pray with you. I want to trust God for you. In any way you have missed it, it's never too late. It's never too late. When you are still alive, you have an opportunity to reconcile with Christ. Yes. It's not about church. It's about him. It's about him who has paid the price. It's about the God who sent his only begotten son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, to come to this sinful world to pay the price. He is the reason for the season. Praise God. I want to use this opportunity to wish you a Merry Christmas ahead, a great one in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Our precious Daddy Lord, we just thank you. Thank you for this word that we have just said, oh God. I pray that you verify it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And I want to lead you to Christ. If you have not yet received Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, I want you to declare this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. I am a sinner. Forgive me my sin. I recognize you died for me. You have paid the price. I love you, Jesus. Be my Lord and Master in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. If you have declared that, please look for a Bible-believing church where you'll be taught and nurtured with the word of God. I love you with the love of God. God bless you. Amen.